So one of the problems I've been having since I set up the office, and if you've been following the channel for a while, you would have saw a video where I kind of made the bench here behind me, and I took all these extra trailers behind me out of storage, and I had all these trailers here on this shelf, display shelf. I've had them up for a while. One of the problems I've been having is just dust and dirt, and there's just an awful lot of dust around, and it's annoying me, and it's getting on the trailers, and it's just like, ah. It's just an awful lot of dust around and it's getting the trailers and it's annoying me. So I came up with a pretty cool solution, I think, to display your 35mm trailers at home or in your office or whatever your workspace, that I thought I might share with you, and hopefully it'll work for you as well. So apart from being a projectionist, I have my own video production business. So I was just had a lot of work on recently and kind of came up with this idea as a solution to displaying 35mm trailers. So as part of my video business, I'm burning off a lot of DVDs and Blu-rays and stuff, and I buy in these plain white sort of printable DVDs in these sort of they're called cake boxes, and I just sort of thought these would work well to display trailers, and I've tried a few and they work really well. So they're literally just clear plastic. The discs are in this. It has this sort of center spindle which sits up through the middle of the trailer. Let me show you what I've done. So here is my Crow trailer that you would have seen before. I've done a video on this before on the channel, and I actually mentioned in the video I was looking for some way of displaying it here on the shelves because I wanted to kind of be in the center of everything that was going on. And these DVD cake boxes came in great. You can see through them, which is cool. So you can see the label, and let me just take this out and kind of show you. So here's how the trailer sits in. Let me just pull this off. So we have that center spindle that I was talking about on the trailer. Send it up through it. It does sit a little bit loose, so you just kind of want to. So what I've been doing is pushing them back and centering them in between the two kind of these two kind of points. And they seal closed and pretty handy. Let me show you where this goes on the shelf. So I've actually been trying these out for a while. I have a few more here behind me on the shelves, but I have a lot more loose, and luckily enough, I've recently done a job where I have a load of these left over. So hopefully I'm gonna get as many trailers as possible into these on the shelves, free from dust and dirt. So there's actually three different size boxes which come in great. You have this cake box holds 25, you'll fit one trailer into this. This size holds 50 discs, you'll fit two trailers into this. And this size holds 100 discs, you should get 3 to 4 trailers into this. Now the other thing I did notice is that the largest trailer I've gotten in on a small bobbin, the largest trailer I've gotten into one of these, any size, is about 2 minutes 20 seconds, 2 minutes 25. Anything kind of over that is not going to fit in, unfortunately. So we're going to have to find a different solution to display your trailers for that size. So that actually took me a little bit longer than I thought. Last night I started all arranging all the trailers and stuff, and it took a really long time. So I just finished it off this morning, and as you can see behind me here on the bench, I kind of changed things around. I put all these in the plastic containers, display things here behind me. If we swing back around to the display shelves behind me, all of these ones here are still just loose. I don't have enough containers, and then I have some in containers up here and then up as well. And the Crow one that I showed you over on the Crow shelf. So that's going to wrap it up for this video. Just an idea I had about displaying some of your 35mm trailers in these cases. If you think this is a good idea that you'd like to do, let me know in the comments down below. How do you display your 35mm trailers, if you have any? And I know a lot of people have like kind of glass case sort of units and stuff, a little bit expensive. And as I said earlier, I just had a bunch of these kind of sitting that were going to get thrown out. So I thought it was a good idea, and I kind of paired off a couple of pairings and stuff like that, and put a lot of films together that kind of go together. So that's going to do it for the video. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you already have subscribed, don't forget to hit the bell so you get to be one of the first people to watch the videos as they get uploaded. You can follow me on social media, all those things. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll talk to you on the next video.